So anyway, I have sketched a little bit. I'm going to be doing a painting, and I'm going to be doing a, what I'm going to entitle, did I do it backwards? No. What I'm going to entitle, the Easter egg hunt. Okay. So we are going to church. See, I always have this story going on in my head about what I'm doing. You know, whenever I'm making something, there's a storyline going on somewhere in here. So this is going to be called the Easter egg hunt. It's at a church, a little church in the mountains, okay, and Mrs. Bunny, she's over here, right here, okay, Mrs. Bunny is going to be involved, and this is a little church in the mountains, and what I did not do, I went over and sketched the church here, over here, there we go, I'm backwards to y'all, over here, I've just sketched the church, but I did not sketch the mountains, and the reason I'm doing that is because I'm going to be going over it with acrylic paint. And what I'm going to do is, it's still going to show me the black, hopefully the black marker behind it all. Cause that is going to give me my direction here. And this shouldn't be a really difficult project. This is really simple. What I did was I looked online for a very simplistic sketch of a church, like a country mountain church is what I was looking for. And I went on Pinterest and I found a couple of sketches and I kind of incorporated them. The things that I liked the best about each sketch. So I kind of incorporated them, said it was a simple sketch and it certainly was. And what I've done here is I've created some trees coming up from here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start by painting the background first and bringing it up from there. Okay. So there's that. I'm going to start with a deep blue back here and I'm going to graduate, up into a white. I'm going to add some clouds in there, but this is called True Blue from folk art. So I'm just going to take this. This is kind of like a mop brush. I want to call it. It's kind of a mop brush. It might need some water. I might have to add some water to it. I can use this floating medium. It's not an extender, but it is floating medium. And when you put it on your paintbrush, it just makes things flow nicer. It's just a clear gel. And folk art makes it. And I like using it sometimes when the paint starts to get thickened like that. And it just gives it a nice flow. Okay. And that's okay. Okay, so this is going to look kind of darkish in the background. Okay. I'm going to follow the mountain line. I'm going to follow it right on over here to the trees. Now this is kind of covering it up more than I thought it would. So I'm going to try to keep it thin-ish. Over here by the trees, because I want to kind of, there we go. I want to be able to see those trees through the blue sky. All right, so I'm going to grab some white out of this. I'm going to use a casement white and infusion mineral paint. That's what I'm using. You can use any acrylic paint that you like. I'm using this simply because it's going to give me a nice coverage. Okay, I'm gonna go in and I'm just gonna dab some pretty white fluffy clouds in here, right over the blue. Okay. Okay, so the mountains, we want this. I've got a couple of greens here. I've got a dark, what do they call this? Black forest green. I probably don't need anything this dark, but I probably will mix it a little bit and lighten it up in some spots. This is dark forest green by Deco Art. I also have a green called Italian Sage, which is one of my very favorites. And I will probably add a little of this on top, but okay, there we go. just a little bit. And brush do I want here? This big, fat, big one. Now this is a really ratted out, bad slap it on brush, but I'm gonna go in here with a little bit of this white, start with the white, and I'm gonna grab up a little bit of the green. I'm gonna change this value of this green just a little bit, okay? I don't want it so dark that the trees aren't gonna show up when I do them. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go in here and start pouncing. And what you're gonna see, it's gonna make it look like there's some vegetation up here in the midst of this, in the mountains. Right, and I'm gonna go right up to that mountaintop line, okay? And I'm very carefully going around the church because it's going to get painted like that. Just a little bit more. And it's okay if your value is ever so slightly different as you remix them, because with vegetation, it's not all the same color, you know, it's all mixed. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to mix it. There we go. Good enough. All right. It's looking storybook-ish.
All right.
All right. So now we got this going on. Is it looking storybook-ish? I love to paint storybook-ish. All right. So next on the agenda here is this little white church in the mountains. And I'm going to make some of it white with a dab, and I mean a dab, of blue, because that will make it not white. What's the word I'm looking for here? It'll make it not completely white, like the background here that it already is. It's gonna make it just a little bit like it's taking on the color of the sky, right? So I'm gonna just grab up some of this, just a dab of that blue. I'm gonna mix it right into that white. And you're not even gonna be able to tell that's not white when I put it on there. It'll almost look like a sky blue. But against all these other colors, it's gonna look white. Okay, here I go. Make it gray. Well, the stone is gonna be gray. Let's see. So, I just think that I make it kind of marbleized like that. Yeah, add some black and make the stone. A little stone church in the mountains. I'm gonna go ahead with the windows. The windows are gonna have a podge yellow. I'm gonna make them very bright. I think that's what it's called, podge yellow, yep. It's podge yellow. Get in there with a script liner brush because these tiny ones are really tiny. And you need a tiny brush for that. Okay, we're getting there. We are. I am going to go for red. Red. I think that'll look really cool. They have a red door in this mix. I can do another one here. I really don't need that much. I think I can just fit a little red right in here. There we go. I only need a dab. Right? This is an angled, a very small angled brush, and it will allow me to get around the curves of this a little more easily. And start at the top and pull it down. Turn this to where I can get to it a little bit better. I'm gonna push that back. My computer will be a mess. All right, what I'm gonna do here is right here at the roof line where the pitch is, I'm gonna make that part brown. I like it, it's kind of got dark and light tones to it. So kind of like that. All right, now I need a really tiny script liner brush for this piece here, because right up along this chimney where the steeple is gonna, where that's the steeple and the cross is going to go, it's very, 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 very narrow and thin. So I'm just going to take my script liner brush, go right down. Right down that line. Okay, going into the black for the roof line. Grabbing the black. Starting at the bottom, I'm going to put in one shingle here. And I'm just going to go right next to it, put in the next one. And I'm going to go right next to that one, and put in the next one, and then the next one. Okay. It's going to be interesting doing this roof line. See there? There's that. Okay, do the other side, same thing. Right around the door there, I kind of want that door to have a little bit of interest there too. So I'm gonna go ahead and put a couple of those stones inside this area here. All right, so I'm gonna leave this church alone, I think, at this point. I'm pretty sure. I might go back later and tweak some things, give it some shading and whatnot, you know. But right now we're gonna get over here to to what you guys are going, what is that? This is going to be an Easter, or not an Easter bunny. It's going to be a bunny mom. It's gonna be a bunny mom. And let me just go on in and paint her up really cute. I think I'm going to go ahead and use some of the colors I have on my palette here. Take some of this white blue, and I'm going to add some of the red. I'm going to give her a kind of a, almost a pink, pretty pink. Because it is Easter, and it is an Easter egg hunt, right? We're just going to mix up a little bit of pink in here. And give her a pretty pink dress. A little bit of white here, just a little bit. It's gonna go around here and give her her little, pretty little lace scallops down here. And when you go over the marker where I've lined everything, you can leave some of that marker showing, because it kind of gives it a little bit of shadowing. Okay, and I need black. I'm gonna do all of this before I put the Totally Dazzled in. All right, we're in the mountains, right? Remember I said we got mountains. I'm gonna grab up a little bit of that brown and a little bit of that black, and make a really dark color. I'm going to bring up this tree trunk right through the mountains, all the way through up to the clouds, like this. It's going to be a nice big tree trunk, like that. And one right here, right next to the church, is this gorgeous evergreen in the mountains. Goes right up and some more black. I need this real dark green that I got here. And I'm just gonna dab across here. You guys are gonna see this evergreen take form right before your eyes here. Background a little bit so you can see the foliage in the background and that, right? Okay. Last thing I wanna do here is I wanna run a little river through here as well. So I'm gonna take my script liner brush again, and I'm gonna run a little blue river right through here because I can. Yeah, but I'm just gonna run this little river right on through here. Right through trees. Coming along, right? All right, now, last thing I gotta paint on here is some little bitty blades of grass. I need some more green. And some little flowers are gonna come in this field here where the eggs are gonna be. Now, grass is interesting. You can do it all different ways. Let's start over here because I'm gonna, like I said, it's this is storybook-ish. It's not. And using a script liner brush is your best bet, I think. I'm gonna just keep going here with this. Here it is. It's a little tiny stencil brush is what this is. And I'm gonna take the white right here. And around where those, I'm gonna create like little puffs. This is cute. Little bits of dandelions. That did? Created a whole field of beautiful little flowers. I want to hang on to that little bit of yellow there because I'm going to need that for my sunshine. Okay, here's the deal. The grand moment. Okay, I am going to use this piece. It is Totally Dazzled antique bronze, and it looks so cool on here as a big burst of sunshine. This is going to go on here, okay? These two pieces here, these are two silver from the silver pack, and a lot of people would say you wear them like this, but if you turn them like this, they look like little trees, like little bushes. I'm going to add one to each side of the church. We're going to dress the church up with it. I think it's going to be really, really, really pretty. I even took some hot glue on one of my silicone molds. I flipped it over and used a flat side. Put a little piece of hot glue down, and I added just a little bit of moss. I'm going to put a wreath on that door right there. Right in the center. Put a little wreath on that door. A little moss wreath. Okay, now let me get my B7000. Because we're gonna start loading this bad boy up, and I will show you where each piece is gonna go. It's gonna be so much fun. All right, this little piece here is going to go right up here at this point of the church. It's okay, the trees. We're going to use this beautiful, Totally Dazzled, antique bronze. Came in the Easter pack. This is one, the first piece I'm using that's from the Easter pack. Okay. We're going to make this burst. All right. Without further ado, I'm going to show you Mama Bunny. This is the center of her dress. We're going to color it up a little here. Mama Bunny has to have a head. Look at that bunny head. Isn't she cute? Oh. Okay. She's going to be holding a basket of flowers. In her other hand, she's going to be holding this tiny carrot. You see this teeny, tiny, adorable little carrot? Bunnies who are with her are this guy here. He is looking up at that carrot like, I want a bite of that carrot. Isn't he cute? I love him. He's adorable. How cute is he? Right? And there's another bunny. He's even littler than the first bunny. Look at that. You see? Okay. And this is an Easter egg hunt, right? So we've got three of these gorgeous Easter eggs from Totally Dazzled. And these are the last of the three pieces in this set. We're going to decide where we want to put these. I'm just going to put them down here by the one couple down here by the stream, maybe one over here, just kind of spreading them out. Yeah. This is really cute. This reminds me of a storybook page.
But anyway, there it is. There is all of the church in the mountains and the Easter egg hunt. This is
Totally Dazzled sells sparkling rhinestone wedding supplies. Check us out at totallydazzled.com. But before you do, click up here and download our free printable sparkle quotes. Or click down here and watch one of our other awesome tutorials.